And good morning, broadcasting live from Manor Road United Church with Dr. JJ. And as we gather for worship, we acknowledge that since time immemorial, Indigenous peoples have occupied and cared for this land. And in acknowledging this land, we pay respect to the traditional home of the Huron-Wendat Nation, the Métis Nation of Ontario, Mississaugas of the New Credit First Nation, Mississaugas of Scugog Island First Nation, and Six Nations of the Grand River, as our community partners and traditional inhabitants of the lands of the City of Toronto, the region of Hamilton, Durham Region, and surrounding areas. We seek to rebuild right relations with First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples to learn from them and to live on this land with respect and gratitude for its bounty. May we grasp the low-hanging fruit of today. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere. What happened? Spring was saying hello. It sort of still is. The daffodils are about 30 centimeters tall. The crocuses are here, and they didn't dress for the weather. Here we go. But it will come, I'm certain. I won't tell you, it's -7 tonight. What happened to that one? So dress warmly. We have a special meeting of our trustees tomorrow night, and we have a special congregational meeting following our service. And you'll be hearing more about that. It's to approve the $200,000 soil remediation. Just to remind you, when soil is contaminated, we don't have a choice. The hole that is there, we're not getting ready for Easter and having Jesus pop. That was intended to be a short-term project. As you might remember, you'll be hearing more about the oil tank was taken out and had a tiny little hole. And the tiny hole the oil spread a bit further, but the good news is we can contain it, and we'll be hearing more later after the service. Good. And we have one here about building.
Yes.
And tell the good news, you had so many people you didn't know what to do. No, you had no what to do. Okay.
Yes, good morning, everybody. Good morning, everybody. So on Friday, I thought that it was going to be a quiet little rainbow fish day because it was kind of miserable. It's kind of drizzly and gray. But we had 25 people, 30 people show up. So lots of fun little kids and grandparents came to visit, and parents and nannies, all sorts of caregivers. So it was a really wonderful time. This Wednesday morning at 10 until 11 a.m., we are doing our first indoor little rainbow fish. And on Friday, we'll continue outdoors at 10 a.m. on the lawn. Do you want to talk about Ukraine?
Yeah.
Okay, so in the slides, there is a slide that shows all the things that we need for Ukraine. A friend of mine, she's a mom, whose kids have gone to school of mine since the beginning, is organizing. Her husband is from Ukraine, and her kids have gone to Ukrainian school every Saturday all through the growing up. But she sent this out. A friend of hers is organizing housing for 75 Ukrainian refugees to be welcomed to Port Hope in less than 2 weeks. There are 18 women, 40 children, and 7 grandparents. Of course, you hear there are no men because they have to stay behind. She is in urgent need of clothing, footwear, toiletries, bedding, and towels in good, clean condition. Toys and books would be greatly appreciated, as would non-perishable food. These people are all arriving with just a knapsack of things each. So she's collecting things at her house, but Marianne has offered to drive things from here to her house. So you can drop things off here at the church in the next week and a half. And I'm sure there'll be more need coming up for more people coming to our country so we can continue to help, which is wonderful. We all feel, I think, a little bit helpless right now, so it's nice to have something good to do to support people. Yes, Suzanne?
I think there's going to be a GoFundMe page as well.
Yes, and there's also a GoFundMe page, so I will send that out. I'll send it to Marianne. Marianne will send that to the congregation.
And she put it in the network.
Yeah. In the network, okay. We'll put it in the network, yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Wonderful. And also continuing on our theme of helping Ukraine, we have a few things today in our wonderful table. You can buy a fascinator. You can buy an Easter jar. You can buy a pin. So Easter jars, there's only 10, so supplies are limited. So the more you donate, the more we help Ukraine. And also we have the pins, which are quite wonderful. They're a great conversation starter for people. How can I help? Where can I get one? And I think we'll be inundated with this. And our Miss May makes these, so it's quite wonderful. Just, he's got wonderful blue and yellow. Yes, and these Easter jars are full of jelly beans and eggs. They're not real eggs. They're just from Easter, celebrating something wonderful.
And Reverend JJ, how much do things cost?
Yes, cost. Pat?
$5,
whatever you want to give. That's good.
Thank you.
There we go. And how much for the fascinator? Yeah, there you go, five, okay, good. Or whatever you want to give, isn't that great? Yeah, prices are quite lovely, okay. And together we can make a difference for Ukrainian people, yes. Did you hear that apparently there's going to be a Ukrainian band playing with Ed Sheeran in the next little while? And so if you don't know who Ed Sheeran is, he's a very famous British rock star. He's doing a benefit concert for Ukraine. The Ukrainian band reached out to him and said, can we play? He said, certainly. And so it's remarkable. So can we just call up the slides again? And let's see, where are we at? Okay. And this is, remember Michelle from Haiti? That's Alicia, her little daughter. And again, quite wonderful. And we have our many activities this week. Our Friday speaker series includes Joel Fendelman, who will be featuring his film, one of those cutting edge films, Man on Fire. And today we have choir for those staying after our brief. Remember, the meeting's very brief. It's just a matter of hello, everybody. Here's what we're doing. We need to do it. Put your hand up. Yes, let's go. And we'll be extending voting privileges to adherents. Just remember that. We did decide to do that at our meeting yesterday. Yes, there we go. Can we continue on? Okay. And the next slide. And there's a service for peace next Sunday at 4:30 at St. James Cathedral. If you ever wondered what a cardinal or an archbishop in both Anglican, Ukrainian, Russian, all those other traditions look like, 4:30 St. James Cathedral, and I will also be there too. And so I think our wonderful Betty also has congregational care. So Betty, do you want to come up? And you can stand over there in my stead. Here we go. Stand.
Okay.
1 second, let me make sure you're heard.
Privileged to be standing in this place. I am wearing my Support Ukraine. Oh, thank you. I am wearing my Support Ukraine. And remember, it's $5 for all the objects, but if you want to make it a free will gift, you can give as much as you want. The ladies worked hard. Pat made the fascinators, May's done the pins, and Pat had the Rio NHH women help assemble the jars in our nice meeting that we had this week. And as the Reverend has already said, we're very pleased that Michelle had her baby safely. She went into the hospital Sunday and the baby was born Monday. So we're very pleased for that. We continue our prayers for our congregation members facing healthcare issues. And we now add Susan Shaw, Russell's brother, Stephen, to the group. He has been diagnosed with prostate cancer and is in the beginning stages of investigations. Susan has asked that we pray that this is found to be early stage and that it hasn't spread. And she devoutly prays that her brother will return to health. So we do include Stephen now in our daily prayers. We give thanks for Olivier Young, who started his new job this year after a 2-year search during COVID times, and we're pleased to hear his success in finding work and continue to pray for him. We have a couple of birthdays this week. One is for Kyle on March 29th. The other name I thought I would mention anyway, we remember the family of Jan Roberts, as her birthday is this March 30th, and of course she passed away last year. We continue our prayers in the world front for the Ukraine, praying for the children, the women, the men, the families who are torn apart by this. We also pray for those in Russia who are losing family members in this conflict. It affects all people. We also continue to pray for those who are refugees in our world and are seeking a sanctuary place, including some of the spots that are still at war, still in conflict, such as Syria, Myanmar, and Yemen, and many places elsewhere in the world. We pray for the refugees. Thank you.
Thank you, Betty. Thank you, Betty. And we continue. Remember the Roehampton shelter? And remember that as we're trying to shift in different directions, however we can reduce our single-use plastics, that's one way, in a very small way, but a big way, and any way we can shift to using electrical power as opposed to gas. And we come and join in our call to worship. Grace and peace in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And blessed are those whose transgression is forgiven.
Thanks be to God.
We've been summoned to have coffee hour again. Ayla has decided to take the lead in a very good way. So she taps you on the shoulder. She's recruiting. And there's no saying no to Ayla. So there we go. God be with you.
And also with you.
Gracious God, seeker of the lost, draw your children back to your loving embrace and restore us to our inheritance as daughters and sons.
Reconcile our hearts to you, that we may become ambassadors of reconciling love to all the world.
And we come to our Lenten liturgy. So Allison, you and I want to go and put a candle in?
Okay, great. So you take that. Four candles. Circle. If you put the small ones, that would be my last one next to them. Okay.
Thank you, Allison. At the part that comes, the part that says family, if you could read that when it comes up, that'd be wonderful. So in a liturgical season of increasing darkness, we extinguish candles each week. And on these very special Sundays, we think more deeply about Jesus. And sometimes it's hard to know what to do to be a loving person. As we tell the story of Jesus, we learned how to be guided and kept safe in God's care.
We extinguish the fourth candle. Remember how hard it is to keep faith strong in the troubled world. As we watch the smoke rise,
remember that God is with us all the way.
Take me as I am.
We confess that we have strayed from your ways.
Like the prodigal son, we have wasted our inheritance.
You gave us the earth for our home, but we squander earth's resources and hoard its bounty.
You gave us neighbors to love, but we pursued selfish ambitions.
You gave us the commandments that lead to human flourishing, but we break your law and forsake your love.
Forgive us our sin and bring us to repentance.
Draw our wandering hearts back to you that we may find freedom in obedience to your love. As a parent welcomes home a wayward child, so God embraces all who return in true repentance.
In the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. Yeah.
And the peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Peace, everyone. Peace. Peace. Peace.
The long day, work and hope for a new life born. Listen to the Spirit, show you the way. Dance with the Spirit early in the morning. Walk with the Spirit throughout the long day. Work and hope for the new life born. Listen to the Spirit, show you the
All right, Allison. Yes, yeah, so just turn that on and leave that off. That's good. All right, Allison, what do you see?
I can hardly believe that that's real. Is that real?
It's real. It's a cobra the size of a massive. It's about the size of a toaster. The head is, and someone's just petting the cobra. Now, there's not a month of Sundays where I've been ponder to pet a cobra. Would anyone pet a cobra? Not new. There's something about cobras. That we've seen too many things, definitely, yes.
Yeah, and
I'm sure, you know, do you ever think cobras are afraid? Maybe, but not usually, but it's something. So let's look at the next one. And then we come up to, well, on the other side of Cobra Land is where the passage today talks about the Passover. Allison, we had a great Passover on Wednesday, didn't we?
Yes, we did. We had a Passover Seder with the youth right over there in the large meeting room. We all sat around on the floor till our legs fell asleep. And,
and we had eggs, and we had horoset, which is applesauce, and horseradish, herbs, telling the story of the people leaving Egypt. And that's actually a picture, bit of memory lane. It shows Joanne just yesterday when she was 29. No, it was 2016. It was James and Ainsley at another Seder supper at my previous church.
And yeah, James used to be much smaller.
Yeah.
Much taller.
And that's a picture of Christian Wong Tan, the counselor for Citrano Center, a reading to her daughter, a book on anti-racism. So it reminds us how when we take time to be present to each other, we open the doors to being gift. Yes, yes. Indeed. And so now we have a prayer that you created.
Yes, I created this prayer, and as we were praying the last prayer, I was like, oh gosh, there's a theme here. Loving Father, like the prodigal son, we have squandered the fortune you gifted us. The beauty of this universe is lost to your blind children, and we have run through your precious resources till they are strained to the breaking point. Now we look back, ashamed and broken and desperate for your protection. Will you enfold us in your arms and drape your finest robe around our shoulders? We were lost, but we're coming home to you. We're coming home to you.
Thank you, Alice. And Almighty God, by your Holy Spirit, open our minds and bodies to the creating power of your word.
Help us to see the world through the mind of Christ and live in the world as a foretaste of your new creation.
Amen. Now, Fina, we invite you to come to this microphone and just stand right there, and I'll turn off this other mic.
Reverend JJ, we can't hear Fina.
First greetings from Joshua, chapter 5, verses 9 and 12. The Lord said to Joshua, today I have brought away from you the disgrace of Egypt. And so that place is called Gilgal to this day. When the Israelites recamped in Gilgal, they kept the Passover in the evening on the 14th day of the month in the plains of Jericho. On the day after the Passover, on that very day, they ate the produce of the land, unleavened cakes and parched grain. The manna ceased on the day they ate the produce of the land, and the Israelites no longer had manna. They ate the crops of the land of Canaan that week.
Our next reading is from 1 Corinthians 5, 16 to 21. From now on, therefore, we regard no one from a human point of view. Even though we once knew Christ from a human point of view, we know him no longer in that way. So if anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God.
The gospel reading for today is from Luke chapter 15. Familiar, but let us hear it again. Now all the tax collectors and sinners were coming near and listened to him. And the Pharisees and the scribes were grumbling and saying, this fellow welcomes sinners and eats with them. And so he told them this parable. There was a man who had two sons. And the younger of them said to the father, Father, give me the share of the property that will belong to me. And so he divided his property between them. And a few days later, the younger son gathered all he had and traveled to a distant country. And there he squandered his property in dissolute living. And when he had spent everything, a severe famine took place throughout that country, and he began to be in need. And so he went and hired himself out to one of the citizens of that country, who sent him to feed his fields, to feed the pigs. And he would gladly have filled himself with the pods that the pigs were eating, and no one gave him anything. But when he came to himself, he said, how many of my father's hired hands have bread enough to spare? But here I am, dying of hunger. I will get up and go to my father, and I will say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son, and treat me like one of your hired hands. And so he set off and went to his father. But while he was still far off, his father saw him and was filled with compassion. And he ran and put his arms around him and kissed him. Then the son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before you. I am no longer worthy of being called your son. But the father said to his slaves, quickly, bring out a robe, the best one, and put it on him, and put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet, and get the fatted calf and kill it, and let us eat and celebrate. For the son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and is found. And they began to celebrate. Now his elder son was in the field, and when he came and approached the house, he heard music and dancing. He called one of the slaves and asked what was going on. And he replied, your brother has come, and your father has killed the fatted calf because he had got him back and safe and sound. Then he became angry and refused to go in. His father came out to plead with him. But he answered his father, listen, for all these years, I've been working like a slave for you and have never disobeyed your command. And yet you have never given me even a young goat so that I may celebrate with my friends. But when this son of yours comes back, who has devoured your property with prostitutes, you kill the fatted calf for him? And the father said to him, son, you're always with me, and all that is mine is yours. But we had to celebrate and rejoice because this brother of yours was dead and has come to life. He was lost and has been found. Hear the wisdom told to us through the ages.
Good morning. I just would like, Mike Russell, could you just tell me how the piano balances now with my voice? Too loud or too quiet? Just in that chat would be great. Can you hear my voice in the piano okay?
The piano's could come down a bit. I can't really.
Can you hear me now? Is the piano too loud or is my voice okay? Is that fine there, Mike? Okay. All right. Thanks for your help always.
Anytime you say it with heart, anytime you're falling apart, when you're washing the sheets, any stranger you meet, when there's somebody waving. just remember you're coming home to me. It's a world full of barrooms and alleys, of blue nights and red river valleys, when you feel like a shirt and a tie, or like dirt or a lion, and no one can see. You're coming home to me. Just remember, you're coming home to me. When you get to that place that's when just you get under to that the place, stars hanging under the tree at a quarter to three. When you get there, you'll know that's as far as you go. When you get there, you'll see.
There is something about this time of year. We want to hurry up and have spring happen, and says spring says hello and not yet. And I forgot something at home again and again. Let us pray. God, we thank you for the humor of the year when we find ourselves wanting so much to jump outside, but yet reminding ourselves that yes, we do live in Canada and we do have snow, and it is March, and so it is Canada. May we hear and listen to the word again that we celebrate and sing and we pray together. Amen. So often we hear the words long ago in a land far, far away. We might hear the words once upon a time or I remember. We are the story. Every page, every track, every word. And we discover something so profound and so new. It's about becoming the promise. Because that's what scripture speaks about, the promise, then and now and every day and every shape. When we hear the words of the people and we hear that something so profound, let us keep the Passover. And they did. And we so often might hear that word, we think, well, that's our Jewish friends, brothers and sisters do that, yes. But it's more than that, isn't it? Keeping the Passover, remembering the story, telling the tale, holding that meal strong and loud in our lives. When we talk about Jesus in the upper room, he was celebrating the Passover. But it's about that moment of liberation here in Tal. And we hear the words, they ate the produce of the land, about that moment of common meal together. And not only did that was the sense of Joshua bring to that new beginning. And Joshua is actually, think of the word Joshua, Yeshua, Jesus. It's about the person who was champion, who was bringing him to that new place. And we think of ourselves when we've ever planted a garden. What is it like to pick a carrot out of the ground that we've grown, or taste the produce that's grown in Canada? We eat the produce of the land. We discover the gift of something that is grown and nurtured in our own lives then and now. And as we hear, as Paul writes to the Corinthians, but becoming ambassadors for Christ then and today, as we hear about our Ukrainian brothers and sisters, about people around the globe ready to risk and learn. So many people are asking, what can we do? And then we hear word from Alice, and she sends, there's a dozen people coming to Port Hope, and immediately people jump up and say, how can we help? Yes, we're sending money to the Red Cross and overseas, but we also want to know how we can help here on the ground as ambassadors for Christ, as people on the way discovering that gift, breaking in, of Christ who is with us. As we hear in the words of the gospel today, something so new and so deep about a person who's come home, about a person being welcomed. As you hear about the son who says he goes off to a distant land. And maybe I pondered the phrase of that scripture. I thought it's a bit like he went to Vegas and spent money on the slots or the roulette table. You can almost hear that in the background. Maybe he went to Rome or he went to Babylon. But there's something about that, is there not, when the son does that and he began to reach out beyond the realm of the immediate family and created a people. Yet there he went to the father and said, I want half of my inheritance right now. He created a great shadow between father and mother and brother. How often have we heard when a will is created in a family about people suddenly developing this trench and territory of that's mine, not yours? And what happens in that moment in time, that moment of gift, that moment of discovery? But as we step back in here, as Paul reminds us that we are all created to be one in Christ. In our lived experience, we are the story. We're that story of the Passover, of eating the produce of the land, of being ambassadors, of knowing that going to the other land is about discovering a new part of ourselves in the here and the now. But then, as the Father, as the Son returns, the Father sees him far away, he runs to him with compassion and runs out to hug him and hold him tightly and say, welcome home. Welcome home, to sing the song again. I remember this story so well. I remember there was a moment I was the older brother. My brother came home, and yes, they killed the fatted calf. Actually, it was about this largest roast beef you could ever imagine. And I said, what is this? But as I was reflecting on the passage, I also remembered, I'm a middle child. I have an older sister. I am the younger brother. And yes, there was a moment where I had a strange relationship with my mother and father. So we remind ourselves, so often we read these passages and, oh, that's about someone else. We're there. We are the story. We're there in the text. It's about discovering Jesus in the Trinity, that's the place where we are joining with the fruit of the land in that moment of passage. As Joshua hears, I will roll the disgrace away, we hear that great gift of something new and so profound. We hear the words of the father saying to the older son, your brother who was lost is now found. All of us who felt far away are now reconnecting. The people of Ukraine felt a month ago as if there was no hope possibly, and yet there's millions of people around the globe ready to risk and rush and be present for, because we are the story. We are the people who are the living Passover, ready to break free and rush towards and leave the bondage of whatever Egypt was, to find that promised land today, to eat of a produce of a new land, to be the people who are ambassadors of living Christ, to find hope when we go to faraway places, to find that compassion here and now, to be the sky prayer. God with us in the here and now, because we are the story of Passover. We are the produce. We are the ambassadors. We are the living embodiment of compassion. As we move beyond the moments where we have felt disconnected, we find that moment of God breaking in, to know that we bring that light that God ignites inside each and every one of us, because we are that story. We're that moment where the fruit is born, when we plant it and watch it grow, where that Passover is abundant and loud. And we hear the words today again in Deuteronomy that speak to that moment, to Israel and to us. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and keep these commandments that I give you today to be on your hearts with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today, impress them on your children and your children's children. Talk about them when you are at home, and when you're along the road, when you lie down, and when you get up. Tie them as a symbol on your hands and bind them on your foreheads, and write them on your doorposts and on your gates. We are the story, written and continuing to be written. And there is not yet the end. There is only what's next, a new chapter, to be the story of the living God with us. Love born today. For the great diversity you've created, Creator, we come to you with both the joys and the sorrows of our hearts. We're grateful for the gift of life and the joy that it can bring, for families and friends who love us, for allies who stick up for us, even when we cannot risk sticking up for ourselves, and for the great diversity you've created in our world. We pray for those who suffer from discrimination because of their gender identity or sexual orientation or their skin color, who worry about their employment or who cannot find a job, for those who must hide who they are to find housing, and for those who are not safe in our hearts, and for those who not feel safe in their place of worship, help us to end homophobia, transphobia, and biphobia, and all forms of discrimination and hate, and show us the way to make this world a better place for all. And we remember now to celebrate the gift of new beginnings as we celebrate our times of offering and sharing. Remember, online, retransfer. And we remember to continue to share the light in our time of pandemic. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to Lord God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
O God, all that we have comes from you. Receive this offering and with it the offering of our lives, so we return to you only what you have so graciously given. Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear.
All right.
Reverend JJ, you haven't unmuted yourself.
Thank you, Carol. For the church throughout the world, that all the Christians may embody the reconciling love of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the nations of the world and its leaders, that all may dwell in peace and that justice may be tempered by mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And for the planet Earth, God's gift to humankind, that all may share wisely its resources and conserve its riches for our children's children. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear.
Our righteousness will go before us, and the glory of God will be our reward.
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
For our enemies, that we may regard them with irreconciling love made manifest in Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And for those who are sick or in trouble, for the defenseless, the weak, and the poor, that they may be restored to wholeness of life and livelihood, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the lost, for those who have abandoned God, friends, or family, and for those who have never known such love, that they may come to know the joy of love's embrace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
And loving God, hear the prayers of your people for the sake of our world. And as a mother nurtures her children, let us pray.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be. We haven't done this one in a while. And I know it's a favorite one.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed
thank you. Well, thank you, Tom, for that wonderful suggestion of singing the Lord's Prayer again. It's truly a gift. And as we continue to sing as people of faith online and in person, we celebrate who we are as people welcoming to be living compassion in the name of God, Christ and Spirit. Amen. Thank you, everyone, for this morning. And remember to turn on your video so we can see you. And easily, if you could turn off the recording, that'd be wonderful.